What is up, my friends? How y'all doing? This is your boy Sosa Pons coming at you with Chapter 64 manga Dragon Ball Super full spoilers. We had the full breakdown translated. Now, I'm not going to be going over all the new scans. You can check out the videos that will be linked in the description and the first comment, as well as tabs at the end near the end that you can just click on automatically if you want to see a lot of the cool images that have been leaked. We're just going to be going over the plot synopsis right here. Now, I got to this one just a little bit late, so I'm not going to claim that I was the first one, but I normally am the first one. On all the other ones, I was the first one. So let me know what y'all think about this. I can't wait to see what y'all had to say. Please smash that thumbs up like button to help it spread around the messed up YouTube algorithm. Subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, and select the all feature so you can see all my future content. I'm going to be having an interesting breakdown, a different kind of breakdown, mostly about Toyo Tower and the Moro arc in general, along with the latest chapter though tomorrow, coming out right when the chapter is released. So check that out. I'm sure that y'all will like it. So let's continue. Share this around with everybody that you know as well. Here we go. As the Galactic Patrol ships fly through space, one of the Galactic Patrol men suddenly feels as if he's lost something important. Back on Earth, Jocko is confused and questions if Mirus has died. He sees Goku clench his fist. He asks if Goku is all right, and Goku says he learned another important lesson from Mirus, which is that he's not fighting alone. Beerus and Wiz are watching from afar. Now, I already have problems with this. You've heard me rant about this before. I'm going to break this down later on in the video, but I'm just going to go ahead and keep on reading this so I don't waste too much of y'all's time. But not liking that part so far. It seems kind of etchy to me. Anyways, Wiz comments that it's simply a matter of Goku being able to control his emotions or not. Goku says to Jocko that in this fight, he got saved by Vegeta, Dende, and Mirus, sacrificing their own lives. But the difference is, they didn't do it for his sake, but for the sake of the universe. They did it for Goku too. Come on now. He's part of the universe. That's ipso facto. Come on. Goku clears his head, and then asks Jocko why he joined the Galactic Patrol. Jocko replies that he joined because he wanted to protect the peace in the galaxy and because the uniform looks cool. Goku says Mirus said the same thing too. He says that right now he's a fellow Galactic Patrolman like Jocko who is trying to protect the universe from Moro. Moro suddenly flies above. He's ticked because Mirus just beat him with some unknown technique. Goku tells Jocko to fall back. Moro lands and asks where Mirus went. Goku says he's gone, and right now Goku is the only one that can beat Moro. Moro says that Goku is still saying the same nonsense as before. Yeah, he's going full Team 4-star DBZ of Bridge right there. That's epic line right there, and it's true. That he's always saying the same thing before, and same thing with Vegeta and Frieza.
Make your jokes while you can, Frieza, because I can now see the peak of your power, while I'm only beginning to tap into mine.
I feel like we've been here before. Have we been here before?
You see, I have finally realized the legend.
Oh my god, this is happening again.
That's right. You're not dealing with the average Saiyan warrior anymore.
Goku replies that this time it will be different because he just inherited Mirus' will, and then he starts to power up. Back with Gohan and company, they can see the energy from Goku like a storm tall in the sky. Piccolo seems confused on who it will be. It's Dad, Gohan shouts. Dad has finally, Beerus notes that it seemed to have worked, while Wiz agrees. Now show us the completed Ultra Instinct, even though they've already seen in the Tournament of Power, but whatever. Next video coming out tomorrow. Moving on. Goku is now standing still, gazing upwards and aura depleted. Both Moro and Jocko are in shock. Piccolo says the ground's trembling has stopped, but he can't feel anything and that it's too quiet. Gohan says it's like the storm from before didn't happen. That's a weird way of putting it. Goku faces Moro, having finally completed Ultra Instinct. Moro is shocked. What is that form? Silver hair? Jocko questions. It's the first time I've seen that color. Goku starts walking slowly towards Moro, and Moro is terrified, visibly shaking. Whoa, really? And he must know that he's in trouble now. As Goku nears Moro, shouts at him and not to come any closer as he readies a ki blast. Before he can fire it, however, Goku grabs his arm, moving faster than Moro realized. Quit damaging the earth, Goku tells Moro, not even looking at him. Moro tries to kick back, but Goku dodges. Moro aims a punch and Goku dodges again. Goku then strikes at Moro and sends him flying back. Moro is frustrated, confused as to what is happening. He rushes to strike Goku again, and Goku blocks or dodges each of his punches and kicks in rapid succession. Beerus notes that Goku's accuracy keeps increasing, and Wiz agrees. getting better at this Ultra Instinct, mastering even more. Goku dodges another strike from Moro, jumping back a ways. We continue. You, what's the meaning of this? How are you doing that? Moro questions Goku. I'm not thinking of anything. My body avoids your attack on its own. That's why your attacks will never hit me, Goku says. Your body does that on its own, you say? I have no idea what you're saying. Moro says back before powering up and powering suddenly up, and they got the they didn't get the reading right on this one, so that's not me messing up this reading, so don't get mad at me. Goku looks unimpressed as the scene switches to Gohan and Piccolo. Yeah, that's something that I pointed out in my spoilers before, and I'm going to point it out to you once again. That's the thing with Ultra Instinct. It's not just about you being able to fight instinctually or without thinking. Even humans can do that. That's nothing that special. And it's also mostly based on the transformation, you know, the UI transformation. It's mainly based on power and a state of being. Yes, that's true. But another thing to add on to it, just to make it that much more cooler, is that it actually eliminates the electrical impulses that are required from the brain to go to the arm. The arm and the legs and everything like that are basically thinking independently. They're moving independently for themselves as if they have their own brain. Goku doesn't even need the electrical impulses coming from the brain to the arm. That's another reason why it's so much faster and why it's more of like a god-like power. That's just something that I clarified in my Dragon Ball Speed video. It breaks down all the characters and how fast they are and how fast they are in combat. And it's a long video, but it's very, very thorough. Shows every single feat. Make sure you check that out. Link in the description and first comment as well. Anyways, let's continue right here. Now, Goku looks unimpressed as the scene switches to Gohan and Piccolo. Piccolo notes that this time Moro is powering up, intending on going full power. Moro finishes powering up, and Goku calmly readies himself as Moro charges in for an attack. Before Moro can hit, however, Goku seems to have bound him. Goku raises Moro up in the air, still bound, before delivering a fierce uppercut to his torso. The impact of the attack creates a large shockwave that shakes the land, and it can be felt by those at the lookout and even over the rest of the earth. Moro is punched away as Beerus looks on and says that it's perfect. Oh, how unusual for you to acknowledge that, Whis replies back. I have to acknowledge it. That fighting style is godlike, Beerus says, looking towards Goku. Goku notices that Beerus and Whis had come. Beerus tells Goku to continue and to hurry and get it over with so that he can go get some food. Goku smiles and he turns back to Moro, who is now laying badly damaged on the ground, not that far away. By now, you should have realized you don't have a chance against me, Goku tells Moro. Moro grasps at the ground, pulling himself up and clearly in a lot of pain before collapsing again. Do you even understand a bit of remorse for those you killed? That's basically what it says. Do you even have any remorse for those you killed? Goku asks. Once again, they didn't get the writing correct. Silence! For you to preach to me? No! Do you intend on becoming a god? I don't fear the power of gods. I'm the planet-eating Moro. I live by eating what the gods created, which doesn't make sense because you would still be inferior to a god. And as Geekdom pointed out, he definitely isn't above angel level, at least based on what we know so far. But maybe he has a trump card, an alternate form, a full power form. Who knows? We gotta wait and see. I'm the greatest existence in this galaxy. Galaxy, universe, show. So what? Anyways, Moro shouts as he powers up again, his energy sprouting from the land. Oh, interesting. I'll decide if this planet lives or dies. Who has the advantage? Think well on it, Moro mocks. As Goku stands, Moro springs up on him from the ground from behind. But before he can strike, Goku kicks him in the face and Moro falls right into one of his own energy beams. Nice. Moro falls to the ground in a smoking heap and Goku tells him that it's over. Earth isn't one of his toys anymore. Moro realizes Goku holds this planet dear and says, then first I'll eat this planet up. As Moro stands with an arm raised, Goku kicks him back, sending him flying into a rock formation. As Moro attempts to get back up, a huge boulder falls right on top of him. He cries out to be saved. He doesn't want to be killed. Coward! Goku looks on before turning to Jocko, saying, hey Jocko, this guy has the death penalty, right? Jocko tells him, that's right, you can finish him right here. And Goku goes, I see. Then, from here on out, allow me to fight him as an earthling. Goku says as he tears off the rest of his shirt. Huh? What do you mean? Says Jocko. Beerus and Whis seem surprised. Whis comments, it seems he is done with the Galactic Patrol. Beerus has a bad feeling about this. Yes, I don't like the idea that he's going to basically pull another Frieza and, you know, let the Earth be blown up or, you know, wait around and mock and everything like that and try to see if he'll actually turn good like Vegeta did. I understand that that worked out then, but it's not a good idea to typically do. And I hope he doesn't do that, but we're going to wait for the next chapter. I'm trying very hard not to, you know, go harsh on Toyotaro right here. I'll be breaking down a video later on, like I said before, all about that stuff. I'll be reviewing the chapter whenever it comes out. But it's also going to be a breakdown of what things I don't like, especially during the Moro arc. But that's the basic breakdown of this. If you have any more specific questions, I'd be more than happy to answer them in the comments. And I'd love to see what y'all have to say. Can't wait to see what y'all have to say about this. Let me know y'all's thoughts. Try not to be too harsh on Toyotaro. Let's just give at least give him to the end of the arc for Moro, and we'll see what he does with it, even though I'm not liking the way that it's going so far. So like I said before, please smash that thumbs up like button, help the video spread around and messed up YouTube algorithm. Subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, select the all features so you can see all my future content. Lots of good content coming up to you. I'm about to get monetized, remonetized as well, because I lost my old channel. I had many more subscribers on it and did a lot better, but you know, YouTube is horrible that way. So hopefully y'all will help me out with that. Share this around with everybody that you know as well to help beat the algorithm, and follow me on all my social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Links to that in the description and first comment. And I can't wait to see what you're have a wonderful rest of the day.
What are you?
You see, Frieza, you aren't dealing with the average Saiyan warrior anymore.
Oh my god. Vegeta! No, seriously, you have no idea how old that got.